Alright guys, welcome back to Bioshock Infinite. Right now we're trying to bust into Comstock's house until we can get that bird off our back. Let's get to it.
Lady Comstock, how lovely to see you. Wonderful of you to make the journey, especially considering your painful death 19 years ago.
Lady Comstock.
The dress. The thing has mistaken me for my mother.
Your fingerprints do not seem to be your own today, Lady Comstock. Are you unwell?
This isn't going to work.
I think it can.
Your mother's dead, Elizabeth.
Yes. I think it's time I paid my respects. Let's head to where she's buried.
Okay, that's creepy. Let's do it. Assuming she's in Memorial Garden.
There's the graveyard where my mother's buried.
Where are you going?
Come on.
What are we looking for?
There it is.
Requiem in D minor.
It's your mother's grave.
They have her preserved in an airtight chamber. Her fingerprints will get us into Comstock House.
She's your mother.
A mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. Will you open the door or do I have to go in without you?
Elizabeth.
It's her. How are you, mother? Up in there, huh? It's like you and I have some common ground.
Let me do it.
No.
Let me do it.
What the hell?
You see, child, you chose to follow a false shepherd, and he has led you astray.
What the hell?
Elizabeth, are you all right?
Where did she go?
Just hold on, you need to rest for a minute.
No, I'm getting that hand.
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power that device. He opened up some kind of tear.
Is raising the dead.
Okay, catch.
My wound.
Try to keep you soft.
Oh, great.
Huh.
Isn't that cool?
Don't die, Walker.
Tell her to stop. Yep, I'm about to die.
No, 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 fucker!
Is she alive or dead?
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as it truly was,
what reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
She is both alive and dead.
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension
is a dangerous combination. Look! Footsteps. She goes to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
All right, let's go.
It's a shame you have need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
Well, you're sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah, I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm just... I'm not so sure it was her.
All right.
Elizabeth?
I'll see what I can do. Here you go.
What's going on in this place?
You said Lady Comstock didn't belong here.
She's almost feral. It's like she's a reflection of... I don't know.
But I think she found that less believable than her delusion. Lady Comstock seems to believe the child is a result of some errant act of carnality between myself and her beloved prophet. I told the poor woman the truth, that the child was a product of our little contraption. But I think she found that less believable than her delusion. Comstock seems to have been made sterile by simple exposure to our contraption. A theory. Just as sexual reproduction can de-emphasize the traits of each parent, so goes the effect of multiple realities on our own. Your traits dissipate until they become unrecognizable or cease to exist.
Search the top of the house.
Comstock has sabotaged our contraption. Yet, we are not dead. A theory. We are scattered amongst the possibility space. But my brother and I are together, and so I'm content. He is not. The business with the girl lies unresolved. But perhaps there is one who can finish it in our stead.
Generate a magnetic shield. Hold to absorb damage and release to throw it back. Hold and release to create an explosive trap.
The shield might be helpful. Thanks, Elizabeth.
That'll do.
Here we go. plants just grow back? Thanks for you.
That
50% of everything people earn here goes right to Comstock as a tithe.
I gotta get me a job in the profit business.
Take that.
Want to hold on to this?
Order.
All right, let's see. Type three letters to spell the voice.
Three letters?
V-O-X. Try the typewriter.
Well, look at what we found here.
What the doctor ordered.
I know the prophet is a liar, but he cannot be. I know the prophet is a murderer, but he cannot be. For if the future lies only in the imagination of God, why would he reveal it to such a monster?
Did not like this dude either. Man, this guy was like a horrible son of a bitch, wasn't he?
Footsteps seem to go down to the vault.
this sabotage? All their patents?
All of them, Mr. Fink.
Now, why does the Prophet want these two killed?
For the same reason Lady Comstock lies buried. Child.
And why does he want me to do it?
Because only you can make it seem an accident.
I don't think that's the real Lady Comstock. I think she's a combination of herself and my feelings towards her.
What do you mean?
I'm just so angry at her and at my father. I think she's her, but she's also partly me. I'm not even sure I understand it myself.
The Archangel tells me that Columbia will only survive so long as my line sits the throne. Yet Lady Comstock produces no child. I have done what a man can do, yet there is no child. I've asked Lutess about the matter, but even she refuses to help.
God, not this again. Butt cheeks, how they can raise the dead.
Locked. Elizabeth.
Sure thing. There.
Elizabeth.
Got a lock here.
I can do that. It's done. Here's some cash. Here.
Get out of here. place must smell horribly. Going in the right spot? Solving the Irish problem.
Chosen their favorite color.
Seems about right.
Thanks.
I'm ready!
Anyone who knew the truth was better dead than alive.
I'm not even his daughter. I'm just some specimen to be poked and prodded.
No, you are not. Elizabeth, listen to me. What you've been through, ain't nobody in the world deserves that.
Booker.
We are getting out of here, you got it? You're never gonna have to look back.
All right, let's go.
Thank you.
I know you hate me for not being your daughter. And I hated you for not being my mother.
Thanks. Thanks.
To love you, like he pretended to love me.
Mr. Child,
Was a thing. Alright, that's gonna do it for this one. I'll see you next time. Peace.